الحمد لله الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد. Respected brothers, as believers, as mu'mineen, we maintain that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala places trials and tribulations in the path of an individual, then this is testimony that the particular individual is close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this point is made by Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a hadith wherein Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said something to this effect: إِنَّ أَشَدَّ النَّاسِ بَلَاءً الْأَنْبِيَاءَ فَالْأَمْثَلُ فَالْأَمْثَلُ. That the individuals who undergo trials and tribulations at different stages in their lives, they are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Anbiya are the most severe in trials and tribulation because they are the closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every successive generation or level of individuals below the Anbiya go through trials depending on their level of closeness and proximity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ultimately, in the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the infinite wisdom and knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah ta'ala knows that when an individual undergoes trial and tribulation, it could be in the form of the loss of a parent, it could be in the form of the loss of a spouse, or even the loss of a child, sickness, anything that an individual has to undergo, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that the individual has to bear a lifelong experience of living with that emotional scar. And in lieu of that emotional scar that the individual has to live with, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is willing to say and assure you that your stage in the hereafter is being elevated. Because of the immense emotional strain that it takes on an individual who undergoes these particular trials and many other trials, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bears testimony to the fact that that lifelong experience will elevate your stage in the hereafter. And so, Salam ibn al-Muti'. Today we are covering the supplication and the dua of Salam ibn al-Muti'. Rahimahullah. Also, Itabu al-Tabi'i. He would make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He would, obviously embracing and understanding the reality of a person's stage being elevated in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would make this dua. And today's dua is a bit lengthy, but just keep in mind that it is not primarily the dua that needs to be memorized. Many a time, if a new chain of thought is just triggered by listening to how these pious individuals made duas, and we adopt and emulate the same example in terms of the words we use, that is good enough. Our mission is still accomplished if we still make the same duas in our own language, in our own style. As I mentioned on the first day, it is not the rhythm, it is not the shape and form of the dua, it is not the language that matters in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So anyway, Salam ibn al-Muti' rahimahullah, you would make this dua. You would say, Allahumma in kunta balagta ahadan min ibadika as-salihin darajatan bi bala'in faballighniha bil 'afiyah. The dua again, Allahumma in kunta balagta ahadan min ibadika as-salihin darajatan bi bala'in faballighniha bil 'afiyah. O Allah, if you have placed a trial or tribulation in the path of any pious individual, any individual who is close to you, if you have elevated that individual's stage in your court through some trial and tribulation, then grant me the same stage, the same station with afiyah and without that trial. This was his dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That if you have elevated the stage of any individual, any pious individual in your court through a trial, then elevate my stage in your court without the same trial. And this is because as a believer, we don't seek trials. We are weak. We don't see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala places those trials and tribulations in our path in his infinite wisdom that we can and we are able to bear it. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed it in our path. So we don't seek trials. If trials come our way, we bear them with grace. And we view these trials and tribulations in our life as a means of our stage being elevated in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because ultimately that is our final abode. Our life in the hereafter is our final abode. So we seek through these trials and tribulations the elevation of our stages in the hereafter. May Allah ta'ala grant us all the tawfiq and the ability. If we can memorize the Arabic version of it, well and good. First prize. If we can't, then at least if it triggers a new thought of how to converse with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our mission is accomplished. Once again, the dua is, Allahumma in kunta balagta ahadam min ibadika as-salihin darajatan bi bala'in fabalighniha bil 'afiyah. O Allah, if you have elevated the stage of any individual through a trial, then elevate my stage in your court without the same trial. May Allah Ta'ala give us tawfiq of understanding and imparting unto others. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.